fast and agile, and has that pneumatic lift at the front, which if you don't watch out for quickly, out! Oh, it's gone! No! Oh, up is the plane, he's going to get into the pit! Pit! We have a smoker! He's smoking! Oh no, what a great technique from... He's going to get him out! Go on, push him out! Oh, he's back up and running! Now that's tactic for you! Looks like Ricky's beaten up. He's been banged up on a little bit there. He looks like that, but there's his weakness. Can he right himself? Yes, he can. Well done. Ricky's back in the game. And it looks like Flo's taken some serious damage. Exposed some of the electronics underneath there. You don't want to get those thoughts inside the electronics. Is in the pit. Oh, no. Endeavour is in the pit of doom. It's between Flo and it's between Ricky. Who's it going to be? Don't let those fools get inside. He may have a bit of the armament dislodged, but it doesn't mean that pneumatic lift is going to be effective, or it may have been effective, we don't know. Until he pushes the button, he's just going to leverage himself into position. Oh, very close. It's a great battle between these two guys. Who do you think should win? Come on, make some noise for your favourite robot. What do you reckon, Ricky or Flo? Oh, good one there, Ricky. Oh, he's getting back to back quite a lot of damage to Flo at the moment. But he's going to get in the pit. No, it's over. 3 minutes done. Judges, what do you think? Who takes the win, judges? They're deciding. The judges are still discussing. Who do you reckon should win, Richie or Flo? Which one is it going to be? That's why we have safety rules. But sometimes they do get glitches. And I think we just witnessed one there as well. James taking it very careful now. Obviously a lot of damage that can be caused from machines like this if you get your fingers in the wrong places. And the winner is Richie! Let us know who you are, Disturbance. There he is. Against Clank 3. And Sloppy 3. Roboteers, are you ready?
Roboteers, get ready. 3, 2, 1, begin.
So Clank 3 makes a good start. He's on the offensive. Oh, what's happening to Sloppy? He's in! Oh, that was very, very quick. He's got 10 seconds to get out of there, otherwise he's out. So, Clank 3. Clank 3 now. Disturbance there has got a very low center of gravity, but he doesn't have any armament. All he's got is power and that wedge. How effective it will be against Clank 3's flipper, we will see. But he's got speed on his side and he's an agile. But will it be very, will it be a match? I don't know. Clank just wanted to get that position right before he flips. Oh, is he going to do it? He's biding his time. Can his servants get out of here? He's all right. Look at that. Chase. Who's the cat? Who's the mouse? I don't know. Remember, they've got 3 minutes and it's down to the judges. No decisive winner is found. After 3 minutes, the judges will decide, but Clank 3 is going to make a final push. He's got him in the pit. He can't get out. Clank 3 takes the win. There he is. Next up, Catharsis. And 722. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go.
3, 2, 1.
So Catharsis spins up that very, very damaging device of the front running. So Billy breaking up. 7.2, 7.22. Go straight into the kill for Defector. Billy hits to the front lane. Absolutely fast. Great. Substantial damage. But it looks like Catharsis is made it out of the game. But look at all the picks coming off Billy Defector. 7.22. Again, he's dominating his run. What's happening now? The hunter becomes the hunted. I'm just trying to find out what's happening now. What was the problem?
3, 2, 1, 2.
Okay, the judges have decided that both Defector and, of course, Catharsis are dead. So that means the winner, by a resounding success, is 7-2-2. That's looking good. And Night Fury. And last but not least, Legion. Good luck, Roboteers. Here we go. Get to the corners, please, guys. Corners.
3, 2, 1. Begin.
Let chaos commence. Oh, he's going straight for the kill. Where's he going? All about positioning. Night Fury taking a pounding. Killer Joel, how much can he take? Smash, look at the damage. Legion's getting out of the way of that big hammer. Although it's made of plastic, it's very thick. Very, very strong plastic. With that big swinging hammer, it's going to get it just right to create maximum damage on impact. So it's all about timing, but it hasn't got enough time. Night Fury has got to get himself underneath Killer Joel to stand a chance of winning against him. Oh, he's going to get him upside down like that. Oh, it's very top heavy. Very top heavy indeed. Can he recover from that? There you go. Oh, he got a bit of exposed electrical there. Night Fury's doing a good job, so is Legion. But can he recover from this? He's hooked! No! That is a weakness. Killer Joel is hooked. Can he get out of it? There's his weakness. No way to leverage that. He is stuck. Yes, we have a winner. So what a shame there for Killer Joel. Spoke a bit of a weakness there, but I'm sure he'll come back for more. Night Fury did a great job, but of course, Legion takes the win. Welcome. There you go. There's Mr. Mangle and Boneyard fighting against Devil's Brute Force. Okay, back into your corners now, guys, please. Back into the corners. Boneyard, all no problem. Maybe James can check the link, or is the timer started? Well, no, I think we're allowed to go in there. James will do it for you, I think. The robots here are allowed just a little bit of wiggle room, so to speak, to make sure that their machines are okay. It's only fair to give them that opportunity. Is that good? Yes! Just a little bit of back connection on his arming pin. So that's good. Boneyard's back at the running. Now look at that spike on Boneyard. That coming down on anything will cause severe damage, but it's also got weak points exposed. Will Mr. Mangle, will he do the damage to these two? Or will it be the other way around? We shall see. Here we go.
Is a problem.
confidence. We have a winner, clearly. It's Gasolator! The penultimate battle of this session. The vault is now locked. It's introducing you, the robot ears and the robots. Up first, it's Little Hitter. And Loki. There he is. Not forgetting, Predator. Now a very complex way to kick this Predator, but it packs a punch. Are you ready for a battle, people? Here we go. Good luck. But a little hitter comes in with that devastating hammer. Pounds away. Loki is just in a wimpy wompy world of his own at the moment. Loki's getting into the battle now, that's it. Smash, smash, smash. So it looks like Predator's main primary weapon is there disabled. Apart from Loki, that's all he can do right now. All he can do is evade. Everything else is pretty much useless apart from its speed. And you get a bit of luck, but it looks like Little Hitter is on the defensive towards Loki, on the offensive I should say. Loki's just taking the pounding. But Predator's coming in for the attack. What is he hoping to attack with? I don't know. But those very thin aluminium horns on the side do take some punishment. Already severely damaged, but it's hanging on. Predator is trying to push. He's trying to position himself to push his opponents into the pit of doom. Loki's on the attack now. Is he going to get any position? No. But it looks like Little Hitter is still functioning correctly. Coming down with that arm, it's very powerful. It's damaging. Loki's getting the battering. He's standing there. He's just taking it. He's taking it on the chin. Guys have 3 minutes, and if it's not decisive, the judges will take over the decision-making process. Looks like Loki's out of the game. It's just a Little Hitter and Predator in the battle. But he's going to smash down hard with that hammer. Will he get out of the way? Will he make one final smash to score points which will make him the winner? He's going for the kill. He's going to go for the kill. Little Hitter is making a great job at chasing down his opponents. What has Predator got to come back with? Is there anything he can do to save himself? But he's just waiting for that optimum moment to slam him into the deck and into the pit of doom. Oh, will Predator do that himself? Get the position just right. Oh, timing was wrong. He may have another 5 seconds. Watch yourself. Don't put yourself in the pit. Little Hitter is waiting for his perfect time. And there it is, another devastating smash on the armor of Predator. But he survives. Ah, there you go. Big round of applause for our robot ears. Well done. What a great show. Now it's down to the judges. So I think the decision is obvious. Who will it be? It's definitely the winner is Little Hitter! Well done! Twisty Sister! And Thumper! Anubis! That was very technologically advanced machine, wasn't it? We shall see whether or not he's got the glory. Here we go. So spin up those primary weapons. Anubis is on the defensive straight away. What's happening there with Thumper? Come on, let's do it. Twisted Sister is out of the gates with that spinning device. So it doesn't does it? Takes a long time and I can see bells broken. Already we have a technical failure on that one. We have another bells off there for Anubis. Anubis' spinning device is very slow. It looks bent. It looks like it might have a problem. It looks like all of them have a problem. We have smoke. We have smoke from Anubis. That much smoke, it's not like a micro fire. You get a lot of smoke off that, but it looks like all of the machines have lost their primary weapons. It's now just a case of brute force. Can they score the points? This is a knockout, remember. The judges are watching. It's about pilot skill now. About rocketeer skill. But it looks like... I think we have a clear winner. Twisted Sister takes the win! Yeah! And he's very happy because he's been doing this for years and has only ever won a handful of times.